holding before Shavuos, the Torah tells us when they came to Midbar Sinai, they camped before the mountain, at the foot of the mountain. So Rashi cites Chazal, it should have said Vayachnu Ha'om. In the plural, what does it say in the singular? So Chazal tell us, of course, they were Ki'ish Echod B'Lev Echod. They were unified at such a level, they were like one person. This was the setting of the Kabbalah Satorah. What does the Torah have to share with us? To what degree they were unified, whether they were unified or not unified? Evidently, it's clear that the unification of Klal Yisrael, the Ish Echod, Lev Echod, was a prerequisite to Kabbalah Satorah. As we said many times, that to be able to have a relationship with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we have to create a compatibility, a commonality with Him. And the basis for the commonality is that we should reflect His characteristics. As we mentioned, Naaman HaMaharal, if you want to describe God, what He is, in His essence, you can't say He's Racham V'Chanun or Erech HaPayim. He's merciful, He's gracious, because that's only the way He relates to existence. But what He is, we have no idea what He is. But one thing we know, He's Echod. Nothing exists outside of Himself. He's Echod. So we as Klal Yisrael, we have to reflect that profile of Echod. Therefore we say in the Mincha on Shabbos, Ato Echod v'Shimcha Echod, Mi Kamcho Yisrael Goy Echod Moritz. We're one of a uniqueness of Echod. There's only one of us in existence. We reflect the unity of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that's Echod. Vayichan Ha'om, that that we're not fractionalized, that that we were able to have this relationship, this is Yisrov Kuchibrichu, Oraisa Chadu, God, the Torah, and Hashem is all intertwined. It's all only because every one of those components is Echod. And because it's Echod, we can have that relationship. Therefore, the Torah goes out of its way to tell us that what was the level of unification at that moment. They were unified, Kish Echod, Belev Echod, we assumed that profile of one, of unity, to be able to be, to have the capacity to cleave to Hashem, because this was the ultimate moment of cleaving by being taken as the Goy Kodosh, as Hashem's holy nation at this moment. This is the reason why the Torah shares with us the state of unity and relationship we had with one another at this moment. We mentioned many times, Klal Yisrael is 13 Shvatim. 12 Shvatim, 12 tribes received a share in the land. One did not levy. The gematria, the numerical value of Echod is 13. So again, our profile is 13. The materials that were needed in the Mishkan, there were 13 materials in the Mishkan. Osli Migdash v'shachanti b'tocham. What is the location where HaKadosh Baruch Hu allows His presence to dwell? Again, the location has to reflect His unity. Therefore, again, the 13 materials that were needed to build the Mishkan, which reflect the Achdus Hashem. So again, the mitzvah, V'ahavta l'recha kamocha, you must love your fellow as you love yourself. And this is interesting. Reb Kiva said, Zeh klal gadol b'Torah. This is the ultimate principle in the Torah. Everything else is only commentary. The story about Hillel and the Ger, where he came to him, he said he wants to learn kol ha-Torah kula al regel echod. He wants one principle which encompasses the whole Torah. He says, Ma desoni l'chavrach al tavid, what you despise, what you dislike, don't do to your fellow. That is the Torah in its entirety. The rest is only, we'll explain you the details. But what is that? That's the achdus. We have to create, we love our fellows, we love ourselves, not to do anything to anyone else that we wouldn't do to ourselves. That is a reflection of the unity and to what degree we're bound to one another. If we have that unity, then we'll have that special relationship with Hashem.